Welcome, Take It Up with Jessica Lee. I'm here with Belinda Joseph, who's the Senior Director of Marketing Events at xMatters. Hi, Belinda.
Hi, Jessica. How are you?
I'm good, thanks. Thanks for being on the show.
Well, thank you for having me. It's a pleasure.
Events marketing is something a lot of companies are doing now, given the COVID situation. No more conferences in person. Everything is online. And I wanted to get your thoughts on how can you effectively do events marketing in this environment. Your company is not very big, you have 230 employees, but you are in a hot space, which is the security monitoring and alerting. And so you guys are doing well. So congrats on that.
Yeah. But
please tell us, how has it been for you doing virtual events?
Yeah, as you mentioned, with COVID happening, it was a quick change, a lot of pivoting that needed to happen. So we definitely have seen a big shift. When COVID hit, we were just in the process of launching our user conference, which was supposed to be live. But like everybody else, we were scrambling. We had to kind of come up with a real quick solution to make that transition to digital. And we were able to do that. The team and I were able to come together and make that happen within a 6-week period. But when we were talking about how we wanted to, produce this event, we wanted to be very mindful of just the current status of the world. A lot of changes were happening. Changes were happening every day, and people were adjusting to that and trying to adapt and figure out like what to do. So I wanted to create an event that would still be really convenient and easy for our attendees, something that's, not going to require too much of their time, but they can, consume the information in small bites, but also still being able to deliver a really great experience they would have had in person. And so how we ended up doing that was really, instead of having an event that would take place over a course of a day or over a number of days, we decided to split it up into like a mini series over 3 months. So, basically the way we were planning to host our event was, to break it up into a mini series over 3 months. And so what we did was each month we really focused on a theme, and under that theme we would have, one or two customer use cases and some workshops. And it really proved to be really effective for us and for our attendees, because again, it was something that didn't take up too much of their time. You maybe spent an hour of their day looking at our webinars and attending a session. And again, they can take in that information at their own time and convenience. And then in addition to that, we've also had to really narrow our approach and really do more targeted events. So we found that a huge portion of our leads that we were getting in previous years came from events. So then the question became, how do you supplement for those lost leads? And so we had to come up with new ways to do that. And a couple of things that we did was, number one was doing really targeted events, virtual events, one of which was really fun. We did a virtual workout with a former NFL player. And then we're also about to host a virtual cooking class with a celebrity chef. And so these are just really unique ways to just kind of get in front of certain accounts, bring some brand awareness around our company, but doing it in a fun way. And then just going back to my point about generating those leads, we wanted to find another approach to doing that. And so we decided to come up with a little series of technical product events that we call demo days. And so these were webinars that we were hosting multiple of them every week. We had 24 that we produced last quarter alone. And from that, we have seen hundreds and hundreds of registrations come in. We had anywhere between 40% to 50% attendance rate, which is really awesome for a webinar. And sometimes even higher than that, just depending on the topic. And then what really helped us, launch those events and really see such good numbers is that we also tied an incentive. So we were doing charitable donations. And again, just due to the timing, right, we would do gift cards to DoorDash or, to Amazon. And so that really caused a really great draw for people to come and to attend the events. And then we also worked with a third party. So we would utilize third party vendors to help us tap into a much bigger audience that we may not have had access to before.
Yeah. Share with us some of the attendees rate, conversion rates, even lessons learned that you would do differently next time.
Yeah. So I think the main thing for us when we were doing these demo days events in particular, right, we definitely had a particular persona that we were going after. And so it was really hugely important for us that we were making sure that we were targeting the right people. And then not only that, that it was net new contacts. So I would say a good probably maybe 60-70% of the people that were attending were net new, In addition to some existing clients that would also participate in these events. And then also, you know, hitting the mark on our targets. And so we definitely have seen, you know, a good return on these events. We definitely have seen a number of opportunities come from them. You know, as with a lot of events, a lot of times it takes a lot of time for these things to nurture. So I'm looking forward to seeing, you know, what more comes of it, but we are continuing our efforts. We are still hosting these events. We, you know, we're tying it a lot back to some of our ABM efforts. We're implementing an ABM program as well. So, you know, we're going to be doing a lot more customized demo days events to fit particular accounts based on kind of their needs and what they're looking for.
Belinda, I think that having attendees is great. Having 60-70% of new attendees is great, but the engagement with them, you know, while they're in that session, how do you measure that engagement? How do you actually keep them engaged so that they don't drop off and they actually agree to follow up discussions?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you know, that's a great question. And you know, one of the top five reasons people attend a conference is because they want to network. Right. And so I think it's really important to be able to still have that component. And so one of the things that we've done actually for our events is where we use Slack to really as a forum to be able to do that. And so what we did specifically for our user conference is that we created a workspace for Flow Live and we invited all of our attendees to join the Slack group. And within that Slack group, you know, we had various channels such as Meet the Speaker. So this allowed an opportunity for our attendees to kind of stick around after a session was done. They can continue conversations with each other. They can ask questions to the presenter. And this actually turned out really well. We had attendees sticking around for another 20, 30 minutes after a session was complete, just because they were having such engaging conversations with the presenter or other attendees. We also wanted to provide different channels based on topics. So in case, you know, they wanted to talk to other peers that were having similar challenges or best practices, they can jump into those channels based on those topics and use cases. And then we also had a section for Meet the Experts. So it gave our attendees an opportunity to talk with us and our product experts and people that, you know, maybe had some technical questions. You know, they can utilize that channel to do that. And so we have this ongoing for the 3 months that we were doing our user conference, and we saw a lot of engagement within the forum, which was great. So again, it's, you know, I think there's a lot of great platforms out there that have, you know, either existing features that allow for engagement, or, you know, you can get creative, like, you know, like I said, like we did in using Slack and providing opportunities for people to communicate.
What other tips you want to share with us in terms of making it fun, engaging, you know, keeping people, especially because I think there's just a lot of online fatigue right now.
Right. There is. Exactly. You're correct. I mean, we are competing with people's time as well as, you know, Zoom fatigue. People are tired of watching webinars and being on video all day. So you got to find ways to really pull them in, get their interest and keep them engaged. So some of the things that we've done, we're a very fun company. You know, our culture is just, but we love to be involved with our customers and, you know, show them some love. So a lot of the things that we do, we bring in a lot of entertainment. So especially for like our bigger events, our user conference, product launch events, you know, we'll bring in a DJ to kind of open up the event or close us out. We've had a magician, we've had a hip hop violinist come and join our events. So really just to kind of really keep it fun and uplifting. And then also having a host, you know, I think it's really key. You'll hear a lot of event people talk about how crucial it is to have a host be a part of the event, because that person really just kind of helps keep the flow of the event going. They're able to engage with the audience. You know, a lot of times we'll, you know, we'll ask our attendees, tell us where they're viewing from. We have people from all over the globe. And so our host will give them a little shout out and, you know, say hello to that individual. So, you know, it really comes down to really having a balance between, you know, good content, good engagement, and still being able to provide this really awesome experience for your attendees. You know, and some of the stuff we have also done, especially for a lot of our lead generation events, you know, we're adding in incentives, like I mentioned earlier, right? So we've done gift cards. And what we found, you know, especially when you're doing like a networking event, like the workouts or the cooking class, or, you know, you're doing an incentive offer, people want something tangible. They want something they can actually have and something that's functional that they can use. And so we've been finding that that's been super helpful. As an example, you know, for our cooking class, we're actually providing the attendees with a meal kit. So it's gonna have all of the ingredients for the meal they're gonna be cooking, and they're gonna be able to bring their families can join them, and they're gonna be cooking along with the celebrity chef. So it's those kind of unique things. And I think that they can actually hold on to and take part in is really key.
Well, thanks for sharing with us about the tips on how to engage with those online attendees. But I mean, as much fun as you are doing now, I'm sure that you can't wait until we get in person at these events.
I am so looking forward to that, Jessica. I can't wait to get on a plane again and travel and, you know, see people. But yeah, you know, I think it's going to be interesting, you know, going into 2021 and even 2022. I think we're still quite a ways off before things are really back to normal. So I think we're really going to start seeing a hybrid of events, you know, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. I'm actually kind of looking forward to that. You know, I think a lot of organizations, when they start putting together their plans, they'll notice like, well, you know what, maybe we don't need to have this event in person. Maybe we can just do this online. And there's a lot of advantages to that, right? There's, you know, there's a broader reach. You can reach more people globally. And then also it's much more cost effective, you know, not only for the organization, but also for your attendees. So, you know, I think, you know, we'll continue to learn, you know, from what we've been doing this year. And I think there's going to be so much more goodness coming into the next year.
Great. Thank you so much, Belinda. I totally agree with you on that. I'm looking forward to having you on the show again next year.
All right. Thank you so much, Jessica.
There you have it. Tech It Up with Jessica Lee, Belinda Joseph from xMatters.